Welcome to this tech tip showing how to create feature caps in Edgecam and what you can use them for. We'll look at prismatic applications first. Turn off the display of the machine and zoom in on the part. Notice that in this part there are several different voids or regions in the part, and notice how the tool path does not drop into those voids. We'll go demonstrate how this was accomplished. If we look closely at the tool path in this part, you can see that while the initial roughing cycle does not go into many of the voids that are active there, the rest roughing that follows it does. And so if we look at the rest roughing, we can see that it is now dropping into those areas because the tool's small enough to drop into those. So we need a way to selectively suppress and control where the tool's allowed to go and where it's not. And that's where feature caps come into play. So we go to find features. On the mill options, you have a pocket caps that's now checked. And on the hole options, the same thing, a hole caps that's now checked. In addition, we've asked for the pockets and hole features in the part, and that's going to be important because the caps are created with the features, not external to them. So as you notice, we have these variety of caps created. Let's go look at the caps and what they are. So we'll turn off the display of the fixtures and we'll change the model rendering to only show the part and the features at this time. So notice these features or caps, they act as plugs across the top of the part. Perhaps it would help if we temporarily turned off the toolpath display. So with the toolpath display off, notice that these caps or plugs, when shaded, are basically a flat region across a variety of areas in the part. And so as a user, all that we have to do is select which caps to keep. So I'm going to just go through the model quickly, visually, and delete caps that I know do not present areas that I want to restrict a tool from. So with those caps quickly cleaned out, I'm down to the caps or plugs that, you know, ideally I don't want roughing to go into those areas. And so if we think about the part as a solid model with those areas plugged or capped, tools can't possibly fit into them. That's exactly what we want to do. So now when we go into the primary roughing cycle and edit it, we're going to go into coordinate input. And in addition to the solid that's already been selected, we'll now add the caps. In this case, it's going to be as simple as stretching a window around all those features. And after selecting those caps and adding them to this, the initial roughing will be updated. And then additionally, the rest roughing that follows also will be. So now when we show the tool path, we can see that our roughing and the rest roughing that follows all avoid those areas that we want to target later with a separate cut, potentially with a separate tool. Let's have a look now at how feature caps can be used in a 3D mill application. This 3D contour part has tool path built, and if we look closely at the tool path, notice how the tool path drops into the voids as much as the ball of that tool allows it. So obviously a larger tool doesn't drop in quite as much if it can't drop through the gap, kind of like a tire on a vehicle rolling over a pothole. But as much as the tool's able, it does want to drop into there because it's been asked to machine the whole solid. Although we don't think of this part as needing features for the top of the part, feature caps will be very useful here. So again, we've created feature caps by asking for pockets and allowing caps to be created, and holes and allowing for caps to be created. You can see that we have a variety of features in the part, and if we go to the layers list, caps are created on their own layer. So if we turn on the cap layer and I shade in the caps, notice that these caps or plugs plug off each of those regions. So the solution here is simply to edit the instruction that's been built, go to the surfaces, and we'll add the caps as well as the surfaces that are being machined to the selection queue, and notice that now the tool path machines straight across those regions as if the tool is not allowed to drop into them at all. Again, simply by adding the caps to the targets to machine.